that since here. 3:35 a.m. Central Time on Friday, May 4th, 2012. And we're going into another weekend of severe weather, guys. I just wanted to show you what's going on, let you know that the Midwest going into the East, also the South here, still under the gun. Let's go ahead and turn on storm tracking and National Weather Service alerts. Now you can see storm tracking is showing hail and damaging winds throughout Kansas, throughout North Missouri, also throughout Central Illinois, just ending at Chicago, then continuing up through Michigan and off to the East Coast, going over Boston and further north. Now also over Kentucky, West Virginia, and south right west of Tampa coming up to the Gulf Coast. And in the northwest, or the west, depending on how you look at this, North Dakota, South Dakota, Wyoming, possibly even Montana throughout the day today, also going to be seeing that damaging winds, hail, and possible tornadoes develop anywhere from south of South Dakota all the way down here into the south central Midwest. Now let me turn off the storm tracking and National Weather Service alerts and just give you an idea of how intense these storms are. Okay, here's the color code down here in the lower left-hand corner. Anything in the white in the center of these storms is most likely hail, and of course these are damaging winds and strong south thunderstorms when you get up into the pinks and purples. So when you see this, you can see just a huge line of storms going all the way to the East Coast, and then further down here at Kentucky going up into Ohio. But I want to show that it's been going extremely fast, and to show that to you a little better, we can look at College of DuPage here. And let me just speed this up slightly. There we go. And just look at the timestamp down below. It's going across pretty much the whole state, half the state of Kansas, in about an hour and a half. And for those of you who've driven across Kansas, you know how long it takes. It takes roughly about 5 hours to cross the state of Kansas. So if it's going across half the state of Kansas in an hour and a half, it's going roughly 100 miles an hour. And it's going pretty quick. It's heading right south of Kansas City. You can see this circle here indicates, this little hole indicates where Kansas City next rat is. It's going to go south of there and across Missouri. It's made a eastward track now. Let's get back over to IntelliCast. Turn on storm track. You can see which way it's going. So that pretty much puts Jefferson City and possibly even St. Louis in the line of the storm. It most likely will go over Jeff City. It just depends on will it break and go north, or will it continue on south? We'll have to wait and see. So if you're from Missouri, just be aware that's a really strong storm heading our way throughout central Missouri. Now the amount of frequency put into this storm is just absolutely amazing. It's been 2.5, 3 days of scalar square, sawtooth sweeps. I'm not even going to go into it. Just, you guys, if you want to go look at it, go onto my website and see all those shots. But overall, really strong storms, going to carry on into the weekend, folks, unfortunately. This storm up here to the northwest is going to pull up more from the south. It's already forming down here over South Texas. So if you live in Texas, be aware, it's also going to pull up near Dallas, come up here into Oklahoma, Arkansas, at some point in the next 24 to 48 hours. Hang in there, folks.